And in this dream, Robot Hell Part 2, things had continued to deteriorate still further along this degenerative path. The robotic vehicles now malfunctioning due to the apparent flaws of such robotization, if linked to central computer systems. It was designed this way for the purposes of further control and the further suppression of awareness, and consequently has the effect of the diseased and malfunctioning world featuring in this dream. And still there were the rebels, as there were in the original dream, fighting a system they had agreed to, and were the effects of. The idea being not to fight, rebel, or bring down the system, but to supersede it, to step around it through real awareness, or become the effect of the duality of creation. Not fighting the system in this dream, however, more so in pure survival mode, but still in a world of their own cause and effect making, and having to deal with it. It seems that despite how bad things get, life and the ears finds a way to reach certain individuals, locating those with a little risk-taking courage, and encouraging those qualities within them, that through awareness they can better survive in creation, wherever they may find themselves. If the species were locked in controlled robot vehicles, yes, they would still, in theory, be a viable vehicle for experiencing the creation simulation, and technically, no pun intended, could still become more aware and recognize their awareness, their real intent, and the ears. Though the controlling element always a factor, awareness will supersede the limitations of the vehicle, or those imposed upon it, as whatever happens to our body vehicles, be it a disharmonious 5G distortion, or to the extent of robotization, it has nothing to do with our real awareness and the real you that operates these vehicles. So always the potential to become more aware, even if through one's poor life choices and agreed upon restriction, one does find themselves in a dystopian robot world of chaos and metallic mayhem. As I can imagine that I and these other surviving robots were those who had enough of a connection to our real awareness that when the computer virus hit, we were affected, I'm sure, to an extent, but with our focus not solely on the vehicle, that we were able to align and view from the position of real awareness. We were less afflicted and able to proceed with our process. A little like how Dwayne suggests that with the advent of 5G, the new you song and those standing real in the new nowness will be less affected by it, mitigating it to a degree. Also, the information I had in my circuits that would return the robots en masse to their factory settings and presumably place the individuals in, yes, robotic vehicles, but ones less twisted and distorted. It was along the lines of the knowledge of the ears, those having the information and the sharing of it, resulting in the potential liberation of individuals from the restriction of creation, or at least providing them an opportunity to better position themselves should they accept and take it on. A worldwide wake-up, potentially, affording people, or, as in this dream, robots, with a better chance to recognize their real awareness, sweeping away some of the agreed upon created consciousness debris that obscures their connection to it with the robot reset. Dwayne provides a view. There's some interesting things coming up. That's for certain. The first part of the experience, the battle. It's not a battle in the sense that wars are fought. There's no battle. Or like the old idea of the angels in heaven battling and fighting devils and demons, etc. That is happening, but that's not us. It's about awareness. But that's what the dark forces and the cabal want people to think. That there's always this battle between the so-called angels and the demons. The battle between good and evil, etc. These are metaphors, but they are actualities because you see them here, but it's all a setup. Battles are all set up, just like the world wars were all purposely planned. Wars didn't just happen. It takes a whole lot to start a war. People don't just have an attitude and a war starts. These things are planned because they are takeovers. The people involved in the first part of your experience are some of the people with us. And through this process of what's coming up, because this is what is coming up through free will. All creation is free will. It's not like there are gods controlling this as people think. This will happen and good will overcome evil, etc. Again, these are just ideas in creation. Creation is all about free will, and that's it. And you can make up any story you like with it. But that's it. The people in the experience are some of those with us or are looking at us. And as this confrontation and reality becomes more in everyone's face, as it is now, with the world burning and the forest fires, the harp, the weather control, the GMO food, the 5G, it's in everyone's face, and people are questioning it. Is this hocus pocus, etc.? It's about recognition. It's not about what you think. A lot of people come from religion where they had prayed and begged to the gods, and they expect the same thing with the new you. If I sing the new you, will I get a better job, find someone, or whatever? But it's not about that. It's about becoming more aware. The people in the battle are the ones that will only go so far. The people that you don't think will leave are the people that will leave. And it has become so, and more than evident, in the last 6 years. I've been presenting this. I've seen it all my life here, and watched people come and go, and watched the attitudes. A lot of people can mentally grasp what's being said, but they really don't see the reality of it, because that's huge, and they can have experiences, all kinds of things, and even with the guides. But it doesn't mean they see it. Life is what it is. It's not what you decide or think it is or are convinced about. It is what it is. So you are actually seeing the possibility of things coming up in this experience. You know this and are given the script to let people know, to give them the hint. There's more to the story, and it's interesting too, just like in a movie, how you get so far and there's the bad guy you can't cross. Somebody who was possibly entrusted all of a sudden has an attitude, and that's in the story too. I've gone through many scenarios myself, and these are a heads up. What the experience laid out is a huge hint that's already in process. But let's see who figures it out and sees it. And so, sing the new you song. Watch your dream visions, and let the whole of life and the real universal guides show you what is real now. New.